Can you tell the difference between a video shot from a $3,500 camera and one from a $700 camera in a controlled studio environment? Well, if you know exactly what to look for, you probably can. But if you're someone whose needs are shots like this one you're seeing now, there may be a vanishingly small difference between the two. My name is Nicholas Johnson, and this is The Space Warehouse. I'm recording what you're seeing now on what may just be the best consumer mirrorless camera for video ever made, in my opinion, the Sony A7S III. This camera has some nutso capabilities, and basically the best feature set available for less than $6,000. It's got in-body stabilization, it's got object tracking, it's got this eyeball autofocus feature where someone can literally be sprinting at you at f1.4 and you'll stay locked onto their face somehow. This camera's got dual processors, a buffer you can't even hit, and it can basically shoot video in the dark. It can record 4K video at 120 frames per second in 10-bit color and basically eat up a whole 64GB memory card in about 4 minutes. It's simply an absolute unit. However, if all you're ever gonna do is record someone sitting at a table talking into the camera like I'm doing now, you can save $2,800 with this little fella, because 99% of the population won't be able to tell the difference between the two. What the ZV-E10 doesn't have is any stabilization at all. It doesn't have a viewfinder, and in 4K, the rolling shutter is pretty bad. It sure does shoot 120 frames per second, but only in 1080p. The 4K maxes out at 30 frames per second, and anything above 24 frames per second has a little bit of a crop. This picture is from the new $700 Sony ZV-E10. It's also in 4K, and in fact, this is a 6K picture super sampled down to 4K. That can make it a little bit crisper. One problem you do get by doing that is a pretty terrible rolling shutter. But you don't care, you're just filming a guy looking into the camera from a tripod. One thing you'll be able to notice if you look super closely, and I'll clip back and forth between the two cameras because you've certainly already forgotten by now, is that because the ZV-E10 uses an APS-C sensor, a literally smaller imaging sensor, a crop body they call it, at the same 1.8 aperture, you will indeed get a little bit less bokeh in the background. The stuff behind me will be oh so slightly less out of focus. ZV-E10, A7S III. ZV-E10, A7S III. ZV-E10, A7S III. And that, my friends, is literally it. Yes, the colors aren't exactly the same. They're not using the same sensor. Unlike the A6600, which actually does use the same imaging sensor as the ZV-E10. But they're both Sony colors, and I'm able to record in both cameras in HLG3 for expanded dynamic range. And with 4K, both are able to punch in up to 200% without losing any quality if you're exporting at 1080p. My point is, if you're someone who doesn't need to move the camera while filming, and you're someone who doesn't need super creamy, just delicious 4K 5x slow motion, with literally no loss in quality. If you're someone who just shoots from a tripod in relatively controlled lighting, you don't need a super expensive camera. You may need the Sony ZV-E10. This video is not sponsored. The ZV-E10 does have object tracking, it does have eyeball autofocus for both people and animals. It can output 422 8-bit color through HDMI to an external recording device like the Ninja 5. It has a really good picture, and it's a stellar interviewing camera. So, to be clear, I'm not making any claim that the ZV-E10 is as good as a $3,500 camera. It's not. The A7S III is a way better camera overall, albeit a little clanky. But for a shot where you're just talking in your bedroom, or in this case, in your hotel the night before you start production on your fourth consecutive art fair in New York City with only 2 days off, this thing might be all you need. Most people who ever see it won't be able to tell the difference. Now, I'm gonna go to dinner, but I'm gonna take both these cameras with me, and I'm gonna shoot a little bit of low light footage of whatever's in front of me while I'm out there. This here was shot with the ZV-10. I'll bet it looks great. I'll bet it looks pretty good, even though it's in low light. Then, this here is the same scene in A7S III land. I'm gonna go ahead and guess that looks good too. I mean, how could it not? I hope this short comparison has somehow helped you make any kind of decisions in your camera buying. Next up, I'm gonna do a way fairer comparison between this thing and the A6600, which share a lot of the guts, and which I'm using to film this little part here now. I'm still in New York City. My name is Nicholas Johnson. Goodbye.